March 23rd, 2015. It's 11:10 a.m. And we're out here getting the garden prepped. Leaves that were up around the garden, my wife's putting out on the, so I'm talking on the camera. And today, with the sun, we're hoping it'll dry up a lot of this soil out here, because it's pretty muddy basically right now. Rained for like the last 3 weeks. Probably every 4 or 5 days it's rained a little bit. Yesterday it was a good soaker. So it won't be ready today, probably tomorrow. Take the tiller across here and then we'll put the plastic out. I don't know if we'll do this today or not, because it's wet. It's so wet. That's the thing. It's just so wet.
We might try it and see how it goes.
Yeah, start putting leaves on the corn.
We'll just have to wait.
We got some mulch. Bird tree trimming services. The owner lives right down the road from us. Told us to help ourselves to it if we wanted it. There's a pile down there. We're going to get probably five of these totes. Let me see, what is that? That's about a 50-gallon tote.
Oh, I don't know.
40, 50-gallon tote. You know.
These 40 gallons. Good for tomatoes.
Yeah, that would be great for tomatoes. That's what I said. Mr. Thomas uses them for stuff. That's the only thing. I mean, I should ask him about that. Yeah, he might sell me a couple of them. I don't know, all of them, they're his, but Mr. Thomas has been helping us for everything else. I would see why he wouldn't sell me about 2 or 4. I don't know about 4, because he's only got about 8, maybe 10, if that many. But we're going to use 5 of them to get some wood mulch from the trees that Mr. Bird had shredded last fall. Left it in his field over there, and I asked him about him last fall, and he said, take what you need, you know, whatever you want. And I said, okay, so we're waiting until now. Like I said, I did a soil test, and I dug up all 4 corners. We got northeast, southeast, northwest, and southwest corners, about 2 feet into the garden. And I was going to do one in the middle, but I thought, no, that's good enough for now. This area right here, in between these tomato and pepper steaks, are going to have to be tilled and kind of put more soil in that area. That's the only place that's really flooded. There was a little in the corner back there, but I kind of filled it up. I built it up a little bit in the corner. This area right here where these tomato steaks and pepper steaks are at are what's going to have to be tilled up and kind of like made a pile inside there, and then use the bow rake to level it somewhat. It's not going to be perfectly level. It'll be, right now it's a lot leveler than it has been since we've been here for 3 and a half years. Matter of fact, I don't know if it's the end of March. I think, yeah, the end of March, 24th, 25th or so, when we moved in here. We lived in a house across the road, which was demolished, but we moved in here. And I've been working this very little by little, and then last year I tried it, and then because it rained 3 heavy rains, in a week and 10 days. It was 3 heavy, I mean, it flooded everything. We were out here trying to use hose and everything else to like make drainage, which was a mistake. I won't do that ever again. But that messed it up last year. We had so many tomatoes, the okra and everything out here. We would have had like 40 or 50 tomato plants. And we ended up with like 3 that were producing anything. And 7 or 8, we had 15 okra plants planted. Only 7 or 8 came up. We got most of those. We're going to plant cucumbers. We're going to have it just a little bit different with the plastic. We have 2 sections out here and then 1 long piece in the back. For, like on this side especially, this half, the western half will be mainly the vines for beans, squash, pumpkin, cucumber. We have to see how we're going to work it, because up in front here, it's about 44 feet north to south. I'm facing the camera shooting north. South is in the back, and then the left is west. From west to east is 55 to 56 feet. I'm going to line that with sunflowers all the way across that line at the very edge, and then the front here on the southern border all the way down here is going to be marigolds. We'll leave a little break in between where the two pieces of plastic go in here. And we got just some fresh mulch leaves from around the garden from this past winter, fall and winter. It's not a lot. It's just in this first two rows, 2 and a half rows. But Wait, so we're going to get wood chips out here in about 4 hours because we're charging up the battery on the station wagon. But, yeah, each total do, I see, about a 10-foot circle. So we'll spread, we might make two trips, and that'll be it. And tilling it in today, if we can, because like I say, it's kind of muddy. That's why I say with waiting for a few hours for the battery to charge up for at least 4 hours, maybe about 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, we'll go down there. Give it the soil time to dry up a little bit up on top here for the first 3 inches. Tomorrow would probably be the best day to do it, but, you know, my wife is like me now, thank goodness. We're rushing to get everything done now. I mean, if I quit today, if I can hold up, I got to wrap up both my knees and I got braces on them. I got to go out here and till this up. She's going to help too, but she's got a bad foot now, her ankle, her left knee, her left hip, and her back. I've got my right knee, my left shoulder, and my back. I don't have my ankles yet, hurting, so we'll see what we can do between the two cripples. 2015 Survival Garden. 2 bags of manure there that I don't know if we'll put a little bit out here or not, you know. We're going to have so much in here with that manure and those wood chips, and then a tillet, and then a plastic on top of all of it. And then maybe today's Monday. Maybe by, actually, I don't know, again, with the rain coming again Wednesday evening, we'll have to play it by ear. We might be out here tomorrow planting. We might wait till Wednesday to plant. But once you get the plastic down, we got to dig it down on the ends, all the way around the plastic, about 12 inches or so, put dirt on top of the plastic to hold it down. I wanted to get some wood furring strips to put around there too, but, you know, wanting and doing are two different things. So we're just going to have to dig the plastic down around the edges. Start with the northeast corner over there. I think we're going to do the side and then the south, northwest corner over there. So the side and the two ends, and then we'll do the inside too, and till it in the entire garden really. But the edges will be down as deep as possible so we can put the plastic on that. It's going to be real hard walking too out here. It's going to be fun. So that's what this looks like. It's 11:14 now. It was not 11:15. I got my phone here. It's 3:23. It's 11:17. Okay, so that's what it looks like right now. This is the first major step. This, tilling it and getting the plastic on, are the biggest steps that we have to do now. Getting those wood chips and putting them out here. Tilling everything into the soil here. And then the plastic. That and the planting, all that, that's the easiest part. But we gotta make sure the plastic is stretched out enough where we can bury it on the ends, all 4 sides of the plastic. But primarily, mostly on the east and the west sides, the west ends of it, the long parts. I mean, you can put it on the sides too, but I mean, those two are gonna be, I mean, it's gonna be rough, but we're gonna try getting that buried down quite a bit. Plastic is folded up in the back over there. I can't see with the viewfinder again. Cracked and the sun is glaring on it, so. Oh, it's back there somewhere. Right behind, yeah, that white is the bottom part. That's going to be facing the soil. Black will be facing up to the ground. Up to the sky, rather. So, that's it.